At the start of the week, Seoul sent a request to Pyongyang to sit down for talks. While the reclusive state has given no response, countries around the world shared their thoughts on South Korea's approach. Kwon Jang-ho fills us in on the mixed reactions.
So far, no word from the North. It's been a day since South Korea announced that they had sent North Korea two requests for talks, one over the issue of ending border hostilities and the other on holding reunions for separated families. Seoul's defense ministry confirmed that there's been no response yet from Pyongyang, and there has been no mention of the offers on North Korean state media either. An official from the unification ministry said this was not unusual and that Pyongyang will respond in their own time. Meanwhile, the White House has given an initial response to South Korea's proposals for talks, which seemed to suggest some opposition. At a regular press briefing on Monday, although White House Press Secretary Sean Spicer referred a question on the matter back to Seoul, he said that the president viewed current conditions for talks with the regime were clearly far away. Seoul's unification ministry responded to this comment on Tuesday, saying the offers for dialogue were for early stages of contact based on humanitarian and security concerns, not fully fledged bilateral talks, and gave reassurances that Seoul and Washington are on the same page. It added that the U.S. has been kept informed during bilateral summits in Washington and on the sidelines of the G20 in Germany, as well as through other diplomatic channels, and has expressed understanding of South Korea's intentions. Other concerned nations have spoken out on the issue too. Japan echoed Washington's view, saying that this was a time for further sanctions on North Korea and not talks. China, on the other hand, welcomed the move. Beijing has long called for further dialogue and expressed hope that the two Koreas can make progress towards lasting peace. Kwon Jang-ho, Arirang News.